All right, here we are for the next section of our AP Biology lessons, and this one is all about water. So this first video is going to be pretty quick because it's just the first section in your textbook, and it talks, generally speaking, about water. So this is section 3.1. So water is a very important substance for life. And it is because of water and the properties that water has that allows life to exist on Earth the way that it does. And water actually has very unique properties, different from other substances, and it's because of those unique properties that we see life as it is. And we're kind of going to go over those different properties that we have. But the main takeaway here is that water is essential for life. Okay? So moving on. Oops, that's what I want to do. So when we look at organisms, we know that water is needed for anything to survive. And that's why when we are looking for life on other planets, for example, or in new areas, we always try to find out if there's water. Because if we know there's water, then there's a chance that there could be something living. Without water, as far as we know, life cannot exist. And the reason for that, or one of the reasons for that, I guess, is that if you look at the cells, which are the parts of organisms, or the parts that make up living organisms, we are all made out of cells, all animals, all plants, all bacteria, all different types of cells. Cells themselves are mostly water, right? Depending on what cell you're looking at, of what animal or organism you're looking at, it could have anywhere between 70 to almost... to 95% water. Your cells are about 75% water. So 3/4 of what you are is water. And that has to do with the fact that a cell, everything that happens in a cell happens in water, in an aqueous environment, right? And you'll remember maybe from your chemistry class that aqueous just means a solution. And when you did your experiment with fish in your closed ecosystem, right? You were looking at an aqueous ecosystem. But the reality is that even if you're looking at terrestrial animals like humans or like dogs or cats, right? We all are made out of cells and we're actually all mostly water, okay? And so because water has specific qualities, we see life existing the way that it does. And so we're going to talk about what those qualities are. So if we take a look here, we talked about this a little bit in the previous video, but I'm just going to recap it for you. Water, within a water molecule, we have what types of bonds? That's right, covalent bonds, right? So within a particular water molecule between our hydrogen, our oxygen, and our other hydrogen, the bond that happens between those atoms is a covalent bond. And you'll remember that we talked about the fact that oxygen is kind of a jerk, and oxygen just pulls the electrons towards it, right? Because this oxygen here is sharing electrons with this hydrogen. However, oxygen is not doing a good job of sharing them. Oxygen is pulling them towards itself, so the electrons are kind of more pulled towards the oxygen atom. And so we see that this side of the oxygen, of the water molecule, is slightly negative, right? And then the parts where the hydrogens are, since they're missing the electrons are a little bit further away from them, we see that they are slightly positive. And hopefully you're getting tired of hearing this, the slightly positive, the slightly negative, but these are all important qualities that you should be very, very comfortable with in order to understand how water works, right? So we have our water molecule here, and the hydrogens are slightly positive, and the oxygen is slightly negative in a given molecule. And what happens, as you know, opposites attract, right? And so we see on other water molecules that the hydrogens of a different water molecule will be attracted to the oxygen of another water molecule. So between water molecules, we see an attraction forming, and we call that attraction a hydrogen bond, okay? So remember, don't let this confuse you. Sometimes people get confused by this. The bond that is within a given water molecule, right? So this bond that's between the oxygen and the hydrogen, this oxygen and this hydrogen, or right here between this oxygen and this hydrogen, this oxygen and this hydrogen, that is a covalent bond, okay? But the bond that forms between water molecules is a hydrogen bond, right? It's that bond that's forming between our hydrogen atom and another more electronegative atom that is slightly negatively charged, okay? Sometimes we call these bonds, these hydrogen bonds, H bonds, right? The H for hydrogen. And what you should keep in mind is that whenever we're talking about any chemical species, the molecules or the atoms or the ions or whatever we're talking about there, they're never just still. They're never just sitting there like they are right now in this diagram. They're in constant motion, right? They're moving somewhere, they're flowing somewhere, they're vibrating. There's always motion that's involved. Sometimes there's more motion. Sometimes it's, you know, they're zooming around really fast. Sometimes they're just kind of like vibrating there, depending on the state of the matter. But they're always in motion, right? And so these hydrogen bonds, you know, they are forming, you know, water molecules will float closer to each other. They'll have this attraction, but then those hydrogen bonds will float somewhere else. They'll be attracted to something else, to another water molecule. So these water molecules are constantly forming and breaking these hydrogen bonds. So it's not that the water molecule just like comes together and they stick, but that they're this kind of like dynamic bonding and breaking of bonds that forms. So that is kind of like the overview of water. In the next video, I'm going to talk about the four important characteristics of water and also about how to calculate concentrations relating to solutions, and it's going to be a little bit long. So enjoy the fact that this video is very short. I don't really have any practice questions. Just remember that water is polar. It's a polar covalent substance, and it has hydrogen bonding.